Welcome to this video on sketching constraints in Autodesk Fusion. I'm Ollie, I'm an Autodesk Certified Instructor, and today we're going to be going through all 12 of the possible sketch constraints within Autodesk Fusion, as well as going through exactly how to use them and what some tips are for managing your sketch constraints. Sketch constraints are used to define the relationship between two or more sketch lines. This is in a very similar way to how joints constrain the motion of two different components in the 3D workspace. We do this to ensure that sketch lines move in predictable ways, which becomes especially important if you have to go back in your timeline to edit a dimension of a part you've already modeled. For example, I have here two sketches, one with constraints added, which are indicated by these small icons, and one that has no constraints whatsoever. And if I go in and try to change the dimension of one of the sketches without constraints, the interaction of my part won't be what I expect. Whereas if I change it on the other one, it will be a uniform movement based on what I have defined through my constraints. This is really important because if I've already modeled something, then those changes are going to propagate through into my 3D model space. You can find all of the constraints up in the toolbar at the top when you are inside a sketch. The first is the horizontal vertical constraint. What this does is it constrains a line either horizontally or vertically. So if, for example, I click on the constraint and then click on a line, it will constrain that to be the closer, either horizontal or vertical. I can also constrain two different objects to be horizontal or vertical to one another. For example, I could click on two circles and they would become horizontal to one another because they were the closest angle to horizontal, or these two circles, because they are close to vertical, will become vertical to one another. The coincident constraint will fix any sketch point to another sketch object. For example, I could select a point and select it with another line to fix them together. This way, if I try to move the line that I've just constrained, it will always stay fixed to the other object that I selected. Similarly, if I select a circle or another object, the central point of that circle will be fixed to the line. The tangent constraint is one of the most commonly used in Fusion. It allows you to select a line and make it tangential to any circular object. One of these side lines could become tangential to the circle, or this line that I have up here could also become tangential to the circle. This way I can move the line, but it will always remain tangential. One of the most common ways of using the tangent constraint is when adjusting an arc's radius to match something that you have a requirement for. For example, I could make this arc tangential to the line that it's meeting so that the arc has a smooth interaction with that other line. With the equal constraint, it's all about size. If I apply this constraint to two sketch objects, it will make them equal in size, or in this case for lines, length. This means that if I change the length of one of these lines, the other will match it. This is also the perfect opportunity for me to show you how, rather than selecting the constraint first and then the lines, you can also select each of the lines that you want to constrain first and then press on the constraint. In this case, it allows me to select multiple sketch objects to constrain at once, whereas if I'd gone the other way, I would only be able to do two at once. The perpendicular and parallel constraints do exactly what they say on the tin. They allow you to constrain two sketch objects to be parallel to one another or perpendicular to one another. So for example, this line can move at any angle until it is constrained to be perpendicular to the one next to it. The fixed constraint will allow you to keep a sketch item exactly the same as it is in both size and location, no matter what other sketch objects are doing around it. For example, here, if I move this one sketch line, it also affects my circle in a way that I don't want. So I could fix that circle in its position and size so that only the line around it moves as I wish it to. The midpoint constraint will fix any two sketch objects' centers together. If I select midpoint, this line and this circle, the center of the circle will become aligned with the center of the line. Similarly, if I do the same constraint between a line and a point, that point will become joined to the center of the line that I selected. Similarly, the concentric constraint will fix any two center of radii for any arc or circle. I could select concentric constraint between this circle and this arc, and the two centers would align, so that if one center was to move, the other would move with it. Whilst the parallel constraint fixes two lines to have the same orientation, this does not necessarily fix them in position. The collinear constraint will fix two lines both in orientation and also in their line, making them collinear. What this means is that when one moves, the other will also move and they will also maintain the same orientation. The symmetry constraint fixes two sketch objects to be identical to one another when mirrored in a sketch line. For example, I could apply symmetry with these two circles and then select my symmetry line, and they would be fixed together in symmetry. Now, if I was to move one or adjust its size, the other will reflect that change when mirrored in that line. Finally, we have the curvature constraint. Now, on a sketch like this, the tangent constraint between two objects would give them a unified direction at the point of intersection. However, the curvature constraint goes one further than this. Not only does it give them a unified direction, but it also gives them a common center of curvature, which means that you end up with a much smoother curve and what is called G2 curvature. You will find that as you use Fusion, it will try and do its best to help you. For example, if I add a simple two-point rectangle, you'll notice already that four constraints have been added. This is because Fusion knows that this rectangle should be horizontal and vertical. In the same way, when I hover over a line while sketching, the simple lock-on appears, but if I approach the center of that line, a small triangle appears, which indicates that the midpoint constraint would be added if I was to draw a line here. I can even combine these. For example, if you click on a line and hold on a circle, it will create a line that is tangential to that circle. I could then combine that with a perpendicular constraint, both already added for me. However, there are times when Fusion will try to be helpful and add a constraint for you, when actually it wasn't what you intended. In this case, you might want to move this line and instead end up moving your entire sketch because of this constraint. To avoid this, you can delete constraints once they've been created by clicking on the icon to make it blue and then clicking the backspace or delete button on your keyboard. This will remove the constraint and allow the sketch to move in the way that you intended. Finally, you'll find that when selecting different lines, Fusion will tell you what is possible and not with constraints. For example, here, if I selected these two lines, Fusion grays out the tangential constraint because I can't make two straight lines tangential to one another. But on the flip side to that, if I select the line and the circle, only the tangential and the fixed constraints are available. You can also see this by right-clicking in the window, and only the constraints that are available will show up in this list. This allows you to really quickly add the constraints that you need and ensure that your sketches are constrained in the best way that they can be. So there it is, sketching constraints in Autodesk Fusion. If you have any further questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below or create a post on the Autodesk community. Good luck creating your sketches with constraints, and see you in the next video.